Howdy folks, thought I'd just do a very quick vlog on the aquaponics this week. Yeah, we had some rodents come through on a raid and they knocked off about half a dozen of the pepinos. Some of the really small ones, so that's no big issue, but we lost three of the really big ones, or the nice sized ones. Managed to save these five, that'll be alright. We'll just put them out and let them ripen up somewhere. But I pretty much all decided to pull the whole plant out. In doing so, I've disturbed a whole heap of ants. There's not so many running around now, but there was a whole load of them just going burko before. I disrupted their home, basically because I only had a very shallow level of water in the base of these grow beds. So yeah, they must have set up camp in the higher, drier areas. What I decided to do, which was a bit of a silly thing, was I decided to put a standpipe in here and flood the bed to get rid of all the ants. And while I was doing that, I decided to dig around. What I've done is dislodged a whole heap of solids that were down the base. You can't really tell now, but I fully clouded up the sump tank. It was very, very hard to see through that. So I've set a whole heap of fine solids through the system. I don't think it's going to cause too much of a hassle with the fish, but yeah, definitely not something I should have done. I should have turned the water off, let it drain, maybe swung this around to one side and then rinsed out the bed or something along those lines. The reason I'm doing all this is because I've decided I might set up some Dutch barrels. I was talking about setting up Dutch buckets, but I think for the size plants I want to grow here, I might use the barrels. These are yellow. Not a good idea to use yellow anywhere around your fruiting plants, mainly because, well, for us here anyway, it brings in the Queensland fruit fly and other pests, other insects like yellow. What I'll be growing in here is galangal in one and ginger in the other. Dutch bucket style, I'll have a bit of a drain assembly in the base that I'll make up and show you at a later date, and it'll just run through into one of the 90mm, or I think they're an inch and 3.5 or 3¾ inch pipe, back just into the sump tank. So that's something I'm working on at the moment. I had my heart set on doing the buckets, and then I thought about just the surface area, the growing area and all that sort of thing. I really think maybe the ginger and the galangal will go better in this size. I was thinking about doing capsicums in there, but yeah, I think what I might do is, because we get the fruit fly here, set up one of these media beds just with a couple of different capsicums in it, and then what I can do is actually net it off to keep the fruit fly out. So I think that's a smarter idea than trying to do individual buckets, Dutch buckets here, and try and net them off. So also too, these guys being a little bit heavier, if we have we get fairly full-on thunderstorms and windstorms coming through here, they should be able to withstand the breeze and not blow over. I'll also tie the base in with some bricks and other bits and pieces, but yeah, I'll sort that out later. But other than that, yeah, not a lot's going on. This poor lavender is probably going to die over the next couple of days. I might try and cut it back and see if I can plant it somewhere else in the yard, but I've got others I can take cuttings from. Just down here, volunteer sugar snap pea. It's just one of the honeypod peas. I'd say a bird's brought it over here, or I've got no idea really, to tell you the truth. Somehow a pea's gotten in here. Another little, looks like just a weed down in there. Whole heap of the broad ripple yellow currant tomatoes, but yeah, we'll get rid of them. Just over there was a whole stand of little jalapeno seedlings that must have come from a fruit that got discarded when it was growing over that side of the bed. Yeah, really not a lot going on. Thought I'd just do a very quick little vlog just to give you a bit of an idea on where I'm up to, just because there hasn't been a lot of progress in here. The other thing I'm doing today is cutting up barrels and compost feeding the plants. So just a bit of a look at something else. Those three wicking barrels, they're going to be turned into wicking barrels, doing a bit of moving around the patch. Those three barrels will be going right where Greedy is. Greedy and the girls. I'm going to have three spice barrels along here, and I'm going to have them all connected together with a joiner down the base, so I can fill at one end and all the way through. They'll fill the reservoirs and have a little exit port down this end. So so I'll give you a bit of a look at that once they're set up. And the idea is to eventually have them hooked up with a float valve fed from that reservoir to keep a constant level of water, but we'll look at that another time, I think. Nowhere near finishing that one, so look at all these ants. They're really not very happy with me. So anyway, I'll pretty much all leave it there. I'll get stuck into this stuff before the sun fades. So if you've got any comments, questions or suggestions, pop them in the comments section below and I'll get back to you. Other than that, thanks for tuning in and I shall catch you next week. Cheers, guys.